Hey guys, the question is, Rubio recently invested $31,500 in purchasing a limited partnership interest in which he will have no management rights in the company. His at-risk amount is $23,050. In addition, Rubio's share of the limited partnership loss for the year is $36,950. His share on income from a different limited partnership is $6,725. And he has $51,500 in base up income and $15,750 in long-term capital gains. Here, question number one, how much of Rubio's $36,950 loss is allowed considering only the tax basis loss limitation? So here, the solution will be only $31,500. Only $31,500 loss is allowed considering only the tax basis loss limitations. Tax basis loss limitation is $31,500. Now the firm has incurred a loss of $36,950, which means Rubio is now left with nil balance in current financial year. And from and here $36,950 minus $31,500 means $5,450 in excess will be carrying forward to next financial year. So here $31,500 is allowed considering only the tax basis loss limitation. Now the B point is, how much of Rubio's $36,950 loss is allowed under at-risk limitations? So here, Rubio has fixed at-risk amount of $23,050, which means less than $23,050 is covered under the at-risk amount. Any amount more than the at-risk amount will be carried forward to next financial year. In this case, Rubio's at-risk amount becomes nil because his loss is greater than at-risk amount. So $23,550 loss is allowed under at-risk limitation. Now point C. How much of Rubio's $36,950 loss from the limited partnership can be deducted in the current year considering all limitations? So here, as per the tax basis loss limitation and the at-risk limitation, the loss will be deducted from the at-risk amount is $6,725 and balance will be carried forward to the next financial year. So here $6,725 loss from the limited partnership is deductible in the current financial year considering all limitations. So here are our solution. In case any doubt, you can ask me through comment box.